Of course, the entire country and all of Africa is talking about the collapsed church building in Nigeria. According to President Jacob Zuma, it claimed the lives of 67 South Africans. Joining me from News 24 Nigeria is Tony Smart. Tony, what is the feeling on the ground in Nigeria?
It's a sad, incident. Generally, people are feeling very bad, because there are relatives, there are people, connected to being one way or the other, in the building. So the general feeling is very bad. And besides, the situation right now is that the founder of the church, TB Joshua, is trying to is alleging that Boko Haram is actually, responsible for the collapse of the building. So that is what is, kind of making people to be raising highbrow, because the alleged footage, he said he saw a chopper, hovering around the building before the collapse. And he also said that they saw chopper dropping chemicals on the building before it collapsed. Something we've not been able to verify. But the government, the state government, is actually looking into it and trying to see, to get a clearer picture of what actually transpired before the building collapsed. Because the engineer that handled the project, so that is actually, being questioned at the moment. Because what we heard was that the building was actually a three-story, and they tried to add, three more stories to the building. So I guess the foundation of the building couldn't hold it any longer. So that was why the building came to him.
Tony, has there been any confirmation from the Nigerian government or even Boko Haram themselves? They often take responsibility for their actions in Nigeria. Have either of these groups confirmed Boko Haram's involvement in this incident?
Presently, Boko Haram has not said anything concerning that issue. I'm sure you were aware, or if you listened to the news yesterday, that they actually bombed at the college in Kano, which they actually owned up to. So if Boko Haram does, if Boko Haram were actually involved in the collapse of the building, they would have come out, to own up, you understand? But at the moment, they are not even saying anything about the collapse of the building. So the allegation that the Boko Haram is actually responsible is something we are not, something people are not really buying. They're not really buying that at all.
Tony, of course, TB Joshua is a huge name internationally, this evangelical preacher. Can you talk to us about his influence in Nigeria?
He's very popular, down there. He's very, 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 very popular, because people from far and near, come down to his church, for various reasons. Some come, they say they come for healing. Some, they come from various reasons from far and near. So he's very, very popular. Yeah. Well, the general belief, when it comes to religion activities down Nigeria, Nigerians are generally religious. So you have to be very careful, because it's a very sensitive issue right here, down here. So you have to be very careful what to say about, a so-called man of God now. You have to be very extremely careful about that. Nobody has come to say the guy is, probably using some other means to some other dubious means, to get people healed or something. But we are just, as in people, the general belief here is just that he is a man of God. He calls himself a man of God. And people have been saying they've gone to his church, it's one problem or the other, and has been able to solve their problems. So that is where, as in, that is the general belief.
Tony Smart was joining us on the line from News 24 in Nigeria. We'll be keeping you updated on this story. Stay tuned to News 24 Live.